LaTeX is extremely powerful to write math equations, and that's why a lot of people start using LaTeX instead of Word to write math equations. But at the same time, it could be a bit difficult to get started, because at the beginning, when you just get started with LaTeX, you don't know, for instance, this syntax to write a fraction. Therefore, there are a few tools online that I'm going to cover in this video, which can make your life much simpler. One is called Detexify. One is this webpage here, which is Math on Quora. I will put a link in the description below. Another tool that I always use is Mathpix. And then finally, there is CodeCogs. So the first one that I want to show you is this one, Math on Quora. I think it's fantastic because you can find a lot of type of functions that you can write. For instance, you can focus on calculus, vectors, matrices, logic, and so forth. So let's say that we want to run a sum. For instance, we want to write this sum here, but we want to tweak it a bit, and we want to add new terms. This allows us to change the source code here, and let's say, for instance, that I want to put a 5 here, I can just change the source code and see how it's going to render. Another very nice thing that they show you is actually they show you that this is not the best way of writing something at the power of n. And if you go here at the top, you can see that they're actually telling you that if you want to write something at the power, so 2 at the power of 10, you should actually use curly braces. Therefore, I think this website is extremely handy because you just have to find the equation that you want. So we want to write 2 at the power of 3. We just have to write 3. We can check that we like it, or we can use this expression here. Then we can go in Overleaf, or any other LaTeX compiler will do. And then we can put our equation. So here, as you can see, I have my document, make title, begin document. In this video, I'm not going to go into detail how to add math equations to your document. It's just to show you the tools that I think are very useful. If you want to find out more how to write math equation into your LaTeX document, check the card here at the top, and I will redirect you to a video on how to add math equations. But if you want to add the equation, we can just put the dollar symbol and then we can paste what we just have copied. Control Enter, we're going to recompile it and we're going to see the equation in line. Of course, if we, instead of having an equation in line, we want to wrap it in a begin equation environment, we can do so, and then the equation will be numbered. We have to remove the dollar symbol and we need to ensure that we are using the package AMSMath. So let's recompile the document. And we'll see that now we have this equation in a new line with the numbering. You can look through all this type of equation, and they also show you some complex one. And again, they show you in red what you should not do. So for instance, I can just simply copy paste this one here in Overleaf. Let's just replace this equation. Let's compile the document, and it's super handy. Super simple to change it, and very nice because you can change it here before having to recompile the document, which takes a lot of time. Detexify is also very nice because you can draw here. So you know that this is the symbol that you want to add to your document, but at the same time, you don't know how to write it or what is the syntax to write alpha. So here we can see actually the score. It gives you a score of the matching, so which one matched the best, but in this case, I want to use this alpha here, and then I can go here, and after my make title, I can put in line, and I can write alpha, and let's see how it renders. So that's great, so we have alpha. We can go on and put a lot of symbols. So like we can put here, we can have the gradient, and in this case will be nabla. And here we can see that we can get the nabla. Alternatively, if you know the symbol, but at the same time, you don't know exactly what is the LaTeX command, you can also try here to click symbols at the top, and let's go with alpha. And again, it shows you that there are two ways of writing alpha, and we picked the first one before, but you can also use the second one. It also tells you that if you want to use the second one, you need to use the package UpGreek. The third tool, which I think is amazing, is how to take screenshot of equations and how to convert them into LaTeX. In order to use this tool, you will have to install it. It is free, up to 50 snips and up to 20 PDF pages. So usually it's enough unless you write a lot of math equations. So I've already installed it on my computer. You can just click here and install it on your computer. But basically this is the tool. So let's just put this page here on one side and this Mathpix on the other side. Then we can just do like this. We can click here at the top and then we can put a rectangle around the equation that we want to copy. And it has already copied to the clipboard the code. So let's go back to Overleaf. Let's just paste this new code. We will have to remove the math symbol, and this is how it renders. We can then compare it with the original equation, and we can see that it did a pretty good job. And of course, you could have used the Quora tool and the Detexify tool as well in order to rewrite the equation, but I think in this way is much simpler, and I think for this reason is a fantastic tool. Finally, the last tool is LaTeX CodeCogs, and here you can select symbols, like for instance sum. I think personally is a very nice, don't have anything wrong about it, but now that you know how to use the other tools, I think they are much better. Thank you very much for listening. I hope you find my video interesting. If you did, please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. If you want to be notified when I release a new video, just press on the bell icon. And if you want, you can support my channel by buying me a coffee or supporting me on Patreon. More information down in the video description below. Thank you very much for listening, and see you in the next video.